What is going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be talking about a couple of stocks and ETFs that I'm personally watching and looking to trade for this upcoming week, as well as a bunch of stocks that you guys ended up calling out today in the Discord group chat. So I would actually like to thank everyone out there that did end up calling out a stock or an ETF. We're going to be talking about every single one of those that you guys did end up calling out in a couple of minutes here in this video. But before we do get into that, before we do get started with today's video, for all of you out there that do find value in these videos, that do enjoy the videos here on YouTube, please, please, please feel free to go down below and hit that like button. It really does help the channel grow. And it honestly tells me as a creator if I'm doing a good job here on YouTube providing value for all of you guys out there. So if you do find value, hit that like button. It's greatly appreciated. So let's start off today's video talking about the SPX, the S&P 500, the 500 largest U.S. traded, publicly traded companies out there, guys. And we start off pretty much every single video talking about the SPX because it gives us a gauge on the entire market. Where's the market headed? This gives us a gauge on what we can trade in terms of individual stocks out there in the stock market. And for those of you guys that have been that have not been paying attention, well, the SPX hit a low back in December of 24th of December or the 26th of December. All the way down here, we can see it. It was right after Christmas or right before Christmas. During this time period, we hit around $2,346. And from there, guys, all the way up to now, pretty much, we've been uptrending, having straight green in the overall markets. The SPX was up at 1.14%, you know, from that bottoming out point. And for the past couple of days, guys, we've been greatly, you know, expecting a pullback. And we finally ended up getting that over the past couple of days. But what we talked about on Friday's video is that the markets do seem like they're pushing back up. They are trading in this channel that we have drawn out here on the 20-day, one-hour chart. And I'm honestly anticipating more green this upcoming week based off of what the technicals are telling me right here on the SPX, right? We can see, you know, it traded on this trend line as a support over the past couple of weeks, right? We can see it held it here, held it here, it held it here. And now, you know, we had that red day, I believe, on Thursday. And then on Friday, it was looking like we were continuing the red until we bounced on the bottom of this trend line and ended up closing the day on a very strong green push, right, guys? This is what's telling me that we found our bottom here based on this 20-day chart, and we could be headed back up this upcoming week, which honestly is opening up a bunch of opportunities and some of the stocks that we're going to be talking about in this video. So without further ado, guys, you know, now that we got a brief understanding of what happened this past week and honestly the past month and a half in the SPX and where we could potentially be headed this upcoming week, let's talk about some of these stocks and ETFs that I do have here in my notes. And there are a bunch, guys, because you guys ended up calling out a solid amount. Some of the ones you actually called out were ones that I was personally watching, and I added some to the list that I'm personally watching as well that you didn't call out. So let's just hop right into it, guys. We have a pretty lengthy list here. I'm going to try to go pretty quick because I don't want this video to be over 20-25 minutes. So let's see if we can do it here, guys. So some of these I did talk about in previous videos. Facebook and Apple, I did talk about in the previous video, actually, and these are looking pretty good right now on a technical basis for potential short-term swing trades. So we talked about the SPX pulled back, and it's looking like it's holding that support on that trend that we just saw on the 20-day, one-hour chart. And of course, you know, Facebook and Apple being two of the largest companies ever, you know, they do have a big weight on the SPX. So obviously, if the SPX is pulling back, you know, there's a good chance Facebook and Apple pulled back as well. And that is exactly what ended up happening, right? We saw Facebook pull back from around 172 down to around 164. It bounced on that 50 SMA. As you know, the SPX bounced on its chart pretty much, right? And now, if the SPX does continue that uptrend, if it does end up filling that gap to the top of that channel that we just saw, you know, this could open up a huge margin on Facebook, guys. From where we are right now at about 167, you know, Facebook, if my mouse works, there it is. Facebook has, actually, we can't even see that, but my guess is Facebook has around 2-3-4% potential for profit from where it is right now. So Facebook is one that I'm watching very closely this upcoming week, especially if the markets continue to push up. And Apple is in a very similar situation, right? We saw it peaked out at about 175. We pulled back to around 168. We ended up holding a previous resistance, which is now a new support level, at around 167, right? And we also ended up holding that 50 SMA on this uptrend. And we can also note that the 50 SMA is crossing above the 180 SMA here, which is a very, very bullish sign for any stock, ETF, index, future that we are watching and looking to trade. So some signals here are showing that Apple could continue this uptrend, especially if S&P 500 and the markets do end up pushing up this week. So guys, Facebook, Apple, two large cap stocks I'm watching very heavily. This week, we do see that cross that I was talking about very nice with the pullback, the hold on top of the previous resistance, which is now a new support, the RSI levels dipping down, which is good. So a lot of good signs here for Apple and, of course, for Facebook. So another one I want to talk about that was called out today was Twitter, guys. So let's take a look at Twitter. I think they just ended up reporting earnings. They got tanked, yup, from $35 down to around $30. So this could be a potential earnings play. Check it out, though. We're holding. It looks like we're not technically holding. We kind of look like we did dip below this previous resistance, but we do see a previous resistance here on Twitter at around $30 on this 184-hour chart here. And pretty much, guys, you know, when we're selling off and we end up seeing that a stock, an ETF, an index, or a future is selling off heavily and approaching a previous resistance, what we like to do is see whether or not it's going to hold that level as a new support, right? And, you know, we do see it's breaking a little bit below there, but it's still around the same area where it's worth, you know, tracking and keeping an eye on this upcoming week to see whether or not it is going to hold this level and slowly start to push back up. But to be honest, guys, you know, if we do see Twitter break the $30 level, especially get back into the $29 level, you know, this one could continue to push down maybe to around $28.50, even $28 flat, which in that case, I'm not really going to be watching it for a trade. But if we do hold this 30 level, right, maybe push back to the $31 level, this could open up a nice fat margin of profit of around 8-10% to the $33 previous resistance level. So keep an eye on those levels for Twitter. Ticker symbol TWTR. And another heavily requested stock was Tesla, ticker symbol TSLA. And Tesla needs no introduction, guys. We all know what Tesla is, the electric vehicle company. This stock has been extremely choppy, extremely volatile over the past couple of weeks, right? We got the news that Tesla's cutting 7% of their workforce. The stock dropped 350 all the way to 280. And from there, pretty much, guys, we've been uptrending in price. And what we can see, you know, let's just get rid of all of this, you know, all these drawing sets here to make it a little bit more clearer for the viewers out there. What we can see, guys, is that we clearly got rejected by this 180 SMA, but we're still holding the uptrend here of higher highs, higher lows. If we're taking a look at these candlesticks right here, and if we can see them on a closer basis, it might open up your eyes a bit more to the trend of what Tesla is on, the trend Tesla is on. right now. So honestly, guys, based off this chart, the 20-day one hour, we're still holding that uptrend. And the fact that we're still holding above the 180 SMA here, that is a good sign that we could potentially push up. But what I want to warn you guys about here with Tesla stock is that this 50 SMA is actually curling down. And if it does end up breaking below the 180 SMA, that is what is known as a death cross, guys. A death cross is a sign that a stock ETF index or future is downtrending. There's more potential for downside in that particular stock, right? Just like we talked about the 50 SMA crossing above the 180 SMA, that's a very bullish sign. If it crosses below the 180 SMA, that's a bearish sign. So be careful here, guys. This could be a, you know, head and shoulder pattern slowly starting to form, you know, potentially on Tesla, which is not a good sign to go along on a stock. But guys, you know, if we do end up holding this level and maybe breaking back into the 310 level, that could be a good opportunity for a swing trade. But you know, if we break this, guys, especially if we break the 50 SMA below the 180 SMA and we break this support that we're currently on right now on the 180 SMA, there's going to be more downside in Tesla stock. So keep an eye on that. Be very in tune with that particular pattern that I just told you guys about. It's very important to keep an eye on that small time frame. But honestly, guys, if we do end up getting back into the 310s, 315s, this could be a potential trade. And especially if we break that 180 SMA, we could be headed back into the 330s in terms of Tesla stock. So that's what I'm looking at in terms of Tesla stock. Another one that people talked about was EA. We talked about this one in Friday's video. And this is a stock that actually reported their earnings, dropped 17%, and they ended up filling that entire gap that they dropped and some, right? We saw it drop 17% here, it filled the gap, and we popped back up into the $99, nearly the $100 range in terms of EA stock, guys. So I personally like EA right now as a potential swing trade, but not quite yet. I want to wait and see if we're going to pull back a bit in EA stock due to that massive, massive green day that we had this past Friday. So take a look here, guys. If we do end up pulling back, and let's say we hold that $93, $94 range, I think that's going to be a very good entry point for EA. Just think about it. If we end up actually... Oh my God, I'm using the channel. That's why it's being funky. Sorry about that, guys. But if we end up pulling back here and holding that previous resistance as a support, that's going to bring the RSI down a bit, and that's going to open up a very good entry in my opinion. But if we break below this resistance, or new support rather, you know, that's not going to be too good of a sign. What we want to see is a hold and then a push back up for continuous uptrend. That would be a good entry point. So honestly, I think a couple of more days will open up a good opportunity in terms of EA stock. So let's take a look at the next one here, ACB, Cron, and NBEV. Three of the most popular stocks that we talk about on this channel and honestly in the Discord the past couple of days, because the marijuana stocks have been on fire. So in terms of ACB here, guys, we can see it's still holding that uptrend, which is a very good sign. Unlike Cron and CGC, I believe both of those have broken their uptrends, but ACB is still holding the 50 SMA, and it honestly looks like it's still holding this trend in general. But what I want to warn you guys about is a potential... This honestly looks like it could be a potential double top here in terms of these past two trading days. We can see we popped up to around 770 here, and then we didn't end up breaking above it there the next day, which would have been a great sign for the continuation of an uptrend, but we actually got rejected, and now it's looking like we're going to test that 50 SMA this upcoming week again. So very simple on ACB here, guys, Aurora Cannabis. If we break this 50 SMA to the downside, that's not going to be too good of a sign to trade this. But if we hold this, you know, end up pushing back into the 770s, maybe 780s, that will open up a good opportunity in terms of ACB here. So the next one I want to talk about is Cron. And Cron is looking like a head and shoulders pattern right now, which is not too good of a sign to go long on a stock, right? We can see, you know, the top off at $25. It kind of looks like a deformed head and shoulders here, the one shoulders here. The next one could potentially be here, but just like ACB, and you know, we had trouble breaking that level two times, and now it's like we're dipping. It looks like we're dipping below the 50 SMA, which is not too good of a sign here for the continuation of an uptrend. And it honestly looks like this could be the start of a head and shoulders pattern here. So on the 20-day, you know, we're still holding that 180 SMA. So keep an eye if we do break this, guys. And of course, if the 50 crosses the 180 SMA, those are two bearish signs. If A, we break this as a support. And again, if the 50 crosses below the 180, that's the death cross. That is going to be a bearish sign for Kron. And honestly, guys, I'm scared to trade these marijuana stocks at these levels anyway. I've been saying over the past couple of trading videos that I do see, you know, a potential pullback, and I'm still sticking by those words in terms of these marijuana stocks. And the same thing here with NBEV. It looks like we did end up double tapping here, which is a bearish sign in terms of NBEV, but we still are holding this uptrend on the 180 SMA support here technically. So what we would want to see, let me just quickly you know, clear this for you guys, but what we would want to see first and foremost, guys, is a break below the 180 SMA and a break below this trend line that I just drew for you guys. So this is very interesting here, guys. You know, if we do end up holding this, you know, that's going to be a very good sign for a potential trade if we do hold this, bounce, and push to the upside. But if we do break it, guys, that's not going to be what I want to see in terms of trading NBEV, ticker symbol NBEV. So a couple of more that you guys ended up calling out here. We have ticker symbol MAT. Let's take a look at this one. Oh, I already took a look at this one briefly before the video. Honestly, this is a stock right here that's screaming pullback in my personal opinion. So at these levels, I personally wouldn't get in. I would like to see a pullback to at least, you know, $14.50, maybe $13, $13.50, $14 before considering getting in. But the fact that we did end up breaking this 180 SMA resistance here, that is a good sign that overall the trend is reversing to the upside. So take a look. Keep a look up at this one, guys, for a pullback. That could open up a nice particular potential entry in terms of MAT. Another one I want to talk about that was called out was ticker symbol COTY, and I believe this one was very similar. Yeah, very similar. It's looking like it's a bit overbought right now, so a pullback might be a good opportunity for an entry. And I also like that the fact it broke that 180/50 SMA resistance. The uptrend, it's looking like it's you know, starting back up again, especially with this higher low here at about $7 from the previous, and of course the break out of that 180 SMA resistance. Good sign that this could be the beginning of an uptrend, but I want to wait and see if we do end up pulling back a little bit in terms of Cody, ticker symbol COTY. So another couple that you guys ended up calling out today, TWLO. That's one that I think, yep, this is the one that I was going to say. You missed the entry on this point. Whoever ended up calling this one out, you know, the entry on this one would have been very nice on this 50 SMA. But of course, we saw on Friday it ended up doing very well, up around $5, up around 5%. You honestly missed the entry point. Me as well, you know, if I was watching this, you know, that would have been what I would say, you know, the entry point would be at around the 50 SMA right here. So what I would wait for now potentially is, again, a pullback just like the previous two that we talked about. A pullback here and a retest on that 50 SMA would be a very solid entry, in my opinion, in terms of TWLO. So another one that you guys called out, USAT. Let's take a look at what this one is looking like right now. So this one's looking pretty good, honestly, guys. This one could be a potential gap fill play right here. We see the big pullback from 690 all the way down to 313. That's pretty sizable pullback there. And the fact that we're having two straight days of upwards push, this could be a good opportunity, in my opinion, to potentially get into this one if it does end up filling back up to maybe $4, $4.50. And of course, under that 180 SMA, that would put it at $5. I think that is possible if we do start to show some pre-market push and a pre-market continuation tomorrow morning to the upside for ticker symbol USAT. So another one, WDAY. Let's take a look at that one, WDAY. This, you know, just like the other one that we talked about two stocks ago, this one's looking like, you know, the entry point was missed, right? The entry point seemed to have been, you know, right around 184. That would have been a good spot. But right now, honestly, I would like to see if it's going to break this resistance at 190. If it does, that could be another potential run, maybe back up to 195. Let's take a look at some other time frames to see where this stock has been. Oh, okay, so it's very overbought right now on the longer term chart. So honestly, guys, if it does end up double topping here on this 184-hour chart at around 190, you know, that could be a potential short play. But if we do end up breaking, that could end up running a little bit more. But honestly, guys, I would wait for a pullback on this stock before getting in as a potential entry or, you know, as a potential day slash swing trade. So PDD, let's take a look at what that one's looking like. PDD, this one looking very, very solid. Out of all the callouts, honestly, this one might be my favorite. We pulled down from $31 all the way to $25, and it's holding that 180 SMA as a support very nicely. So the pullback, the hold on the 180 SMA, which is really just signifying, the continuation of the uptrend, very good sign there. So right now, what we would want to see is whether or not it's going to start to push back into the $26 range and honestly continue that uptrend off of the support bounce that we do see right here. But keep an eye on this resistance, guys, at around $26. If we do end up pushing above here, that's going to be a level that you want to keep an eye on to see if we do end up breaking out of. So that's what I'm looking at in terms of PDD. So the last one you guys ended up calling out today was QNST. QNST. Let's take a look at this one. So very similar, guys. This one ended up gapping down. It's looking like it's holding that support at around $14, $15. So keep an eye if it does end up holding this support and we slowly start to uptrend and reverse back up. You know, this could be a good potential entry point. But if we take a look on the 20-day 1 hour, what do we notice here, guys? This is, again, another death cross, another bearish sign that the 50 SMA is breaking below the 180 SMA, meaning there could be some more downside to come in QNST. So keep an eye on this potential support, guys. You know, I always like seeing stocks, ETFs, that pull back and open that margin of profit and then watching them, keeping an eye on them, to see if they end up holding that support, whatever support they're at, and slowly start to push back up, you know, making money from that support level. Honestly, that's what I like to see in stocks. I personally don't chase stocks that are already at their tops, right? I like to see stocks that are pulling back, opening up that margin so I can hop in at a potential support point and then make money on the upside, right? So thank you again for everyone calling out these stocks. Just to finish off, you know, this video, I want to talk about very briefly. Actually, wait, I think I missed a call out. UWT, DWT, someone called those out. Let me quickly do those very quickly right now so I don't leave you out, because I know someone did call that out. I don't know why I did not put that on the list, Das. Oh my God. But I just remembered. Thankfully, I just remembered right now at the end of this video. But anyway, UWT, DWT, they trade on crude oil. DWT is going up in price when crude oil is selling off, and UWT is going up in price when crude oil is going up in price. So pretty much, guys, what this crude oil chart is telling us is that we're holding that 180 SMA as a support over the past couple of days, actually, from, you know, pretty much the 6th of February to the 8th, we've been holding this support, which is a very good sign. So what I would like to tell you, whoever did shout this one out, is if we break this support, that's going to be a good sign to go long on DWT. And of course, if we break the 180 SMA support here, that could be the continuation of more selling off in crude oil, which again, opens up margin for DWT. But if we end up holding this and pushing back up, getting closer to that $53 level, $53.50 level in terms of crude oil. That's going to open up a nice chunk of margin on UWT. So what I would like to say to you, honestly, just keep an eye on this level. Where are we going? Up, or are we breaking that pattern to the downside? That is going to tell you what to trade in terms of UWT, DWT tomorrow. So I think I got everyone's shout out, call out. If I didn't, drop it down below in the comment section and I'll get to it in the next video. But to leave you guys with a note here, just keep an eye, I can't stress it enough, keep an eye on those levels for the SPX that I was talking about, right? If we do end up pushing up, two more ETFs that could be good plays are going to be TQQQ, right? This one goes up when the markets go up, and QQQQ. So keep an eye, or three Qs, not QQQ. Actually, is it three or four Qs? I forget now. Is it this one? Okay, no, it's definitely three Qs. So three Qs and T3 Qs. Keep an eye on those two. These will go up if the markets go up. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Drop a comment down below. Leave a like. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Let me know what you are personally trading this upcoming week. Are you in any positions? Drop a comment. Let me know. Are you looking to add any money into long-term investments? Let me know. I would love to know. So I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.